The Millionaire Fastlane, Crack the Code to Wealth and Live Rich for a Lifetime, the 10th Anniversary Edition, written by MJ DeMarco, narrated by Bruno Marsala. Preface and Introduction, narrated by myself, MJ DeMarco. Copyright 2023 by Viperion Corporation and MJ DeMarco. Preface, narrated by MJ DeMarco. A millionaire is about as impressive as a used Toyota. When I wrote the Millionaire Fastlane more than 10 years ago, I had no idea the impact it would have. I had no idea it would blow up my inbox and often my physical mailbox with reader raves, testimonials, and exciting reports of transformed lives from all corners of the globe. These awe-inspiring stories now overwhelmingly decorate my home office, a testament to what you can achieve when you retake control over your financial life from a tenuous job market, a feckless cartel of central bankers, and a volatile stock market. Although it has been over 10 years since I wrote Fastlane, its message today is more relevant than ever. In the last 3 years, money has become more worthless, buying less and less. I would have never imagined that once esteemed title of millionaire would no longer mean anything. As I like to say, a millionaire in today's inflationary economy is about as impressive as a used Toyota Camry. So I'd like to be clear. The Millionaire Fastlane is not about redefining financial independence to imply mindless saving regimes, religious stock market investments, and living frugally in a tent down by the river. It is about living abundantly without fiscal constraints, the type of lifestyle that $1 million no longer buys. In other words, you can dine out 4 times a week. You can own your dream house with a fleet of dream cars in the garage. You can travel the world and not stay in run-down hostels and cheap Airbnbs. Yes, the Millionaire Fastlane gives you the framework and the tools to learn how to live the rest of your life like a king, but without the angry peasantry, the buzz-killing budgets, and the 12-year-old truck. Unfortunately, living like a king requires many millions. Millions which can't be earned following the mediocre advice offered by people who lead mediocre lives. Sorry, but if you seek financial freedom but have been brainwashed into believing it evolves from strict budgetary living, fanatical savings rituals, and years of patient stock market optimism, that's not financial independence, but financial enslavement. In today's up-is-now-down culture, financial asceticism has become the new financial freedom. Yes, my friend, you'll own nothing, you'll do nothing, you'll buy nothing. And according to that global NGO funded by billionaires, you'll be happy. Do not buy the BS. The Millionaire Fastlane has never been more critical. Here's how it began. Introduction, narrated by MJ DeMarco. The road to wealth has a shortcut. There's a hidden road to wealth and financial freedom, a shortcut of blistering speed where you can achieve wealth in youthful exuberance over elderly entropy. Yes, you don't have to settle for mediocrity. Yes, you can live rich, own your day, and live a life that most can't. Sadly, the shortcut is cleverly camouflaged from your view. Instead of the shortcut, you're led down a suffocating road to mediocrity. A stale cornucopia of financial orthodoxy cultivated to the slumbering masses, a legion of mandates that sacrifices your wildest dreams in favor of low expectations. That road? It's financial mediocrity, otherwise known as get rich slow. I call it the slow lane, wealth in a wheelchair, or the live poor, die rich financial plan. It sounds a little like this. Go to college, get good grades, graduate, get a good job, save 10% of your paycheck, invest in the stock market, preferably in a low-cost indexed fund, max out your 401k, slash your credit cards, keep a frugal budget, and then someday, when you're 65 years old, or better, 55 years old if you're super miserly, you will be rich. This decree asks you to trade your freedom young to win freedom old. Yes, live poor in your youth so you can die rich old. It's the long way, and no, it is not scenic. If wealth were an ocean voyage, Get Rich Slow would be sailing around the Horn of South America while the Fastlaner uses the shortcut, the Panama Canal. The Millionaire Fastlane isn't a static strategy that preaches go buy real estate or think positively or start a business, but a complete psychological and mathematical formula that cracks wealth's code and unlocks the gateway to the shortcut. The Fastlane is a progression of distinctions that gives probability to the unspeakable. Acquire wealth quickly and asymmetrically to win a lifetime of freedom and prosperity, regardless of whether you're 18 or 40. What Get Rich Slow tries to accomplish in 40 or 50 years, and I emphasize try, the Fastlane shortcut does it in 10 or better, 5. Why can't you drive the shortcut? An old proverb has mutated a few times, but the gist is this. If you want to keep getting what you're getting, keep doing what you're doing. The translation? Stop. If you aren't wealthy, stop what you're doing. Stop following conventional wisdom and using the wrong formula. Stop following the financial plan that prioritizes survival over thriving. I call it anti-advice, and much of this book follows this prescription. This book lists nearly 300 wealth distinctions designed to crack the code to wealth so you can expose wealth's asymmetrical shortcut. The distinctions are directional markers to stop your old ways of thinking and acting and reorient you into a new direction. In essence, you must unlearn what you have learned. Your reality doesn't change mine. You know, I've never been good at sugarcoating the truth. As such, I present the Fastlane in a tough love format. While this book is opinionated, you must seek your own truth. The Fastlane might insult, offend, or challenge you because it will violate everything you've been taught. It will contradict the teachings of your parents, your teachers, and your favorite investment websites. And since I violate all that society represents, and certain agendas, you can bet mediocre minds will take issue. Thankfully, your belief, or disbelief, of Fastlane strategy doesn't change my reality. It only changes yours. Let me repeat. Your opinion of the Fastlane doesn't change, and cannot change, my reality. Its purpose is to change yours. So let me tell you about my reality. Every morning for more than 20 years, I've lived a life better than most monarchs in human history, minus the overbearing footmen and valets. When I wake up in the morning, I pinch myself black and blue just to confirm it's real. Ouch, it is real. Yes, perspective and gratitude are part of my daily routine, as is happiness. Year after year, I get to do what few people can. I wake up when I want, I do what I want, I live how I want, and no, cheap, miserly living, the kind fervently promoted on most financial rags nowadays, is not part of my life. There's a unique joy in driving what you want, living how you want, and dining out as frequently as you want, and without cost as a consideration. Or thanks to the global pandemic and its lockdown mandates, having food hand-delivered to your front door. Speaking of front doors, my home looks, and sometimes feels, more like a luxurious private resort rather than a single-family home. With nearly 13,000 square feet at the base of the beautiful Wasatch Mountains in Alpine, Utah, the word house is an understatement. It has everything one could want and more. A lush backyard with its own private creek putting most national park campgrounds to shame? Check. Indoor basketball court, a private gym, an expansive library, and a booming home theater that could rival any commercial cineplex? Check. Lap pool, 10-person hot tub for raucous late-night parties? Check. Okay, just joking about the parties. In the mood to shoot pool or a few games of Papa Shot? Perhaps a round of pickleball, ping pong, or darts? No problem. Good times are rolling at the DeMarco crib. But it gets better. Every day is, or could be, a Saturday. Although the publishing company and the software business I co-founded keeps me quite busy, I have no job and no boss. I wasn't kidding. I live better than royalty, complete with weekly massages, personal chefs, thanks DoorDash, and a group of maintenance crews to keep it all operating efficiently. Simply put, I've designed my life to feel like a vacation. While my palatial home might insinuate a lot of reckless and extravagant spending, I don't own lavish jewelry, designer clothes, or a watch more expensive than $750. While I used to own a variety of exotic cars, mostly Lamborghinis, I outgrew that phase and swapped that ostentatiousness for 11 jaw-dropping acres in Sedona, Arizona. Now I prefer a rock-crawling ATV that can adventurously take me to unmolested, beautiful swaths of nature. Side note, you need to put Sedona on your bucket list. Going forward, I still shop at Costco, Kohl's, and whichever store is convenient. Yes, that includes Walmart, but only if the parking lot is empty. No, I didn't drive my Lamborghini to Walmart. That might cause a disruption in the space-time continuum. Us Trekkies know better. So unless I'm walking through the Bellagio in Las Vegas, I rarely look at prices. If I want it, I buy it. It is real financial freedom, not financial asceticism as peddled today by mediocre millionaires, the kind that involves punitive lifestyles more befit for a homeless beggar. While I mainly paid cash for my home, I am primarily debt-free. Hey, if you can get a $1.8 million loan at 2.25% interest, I highly recommend it. While I have a slew of credit cards, the banks hate me. Every balance is paid off monthly, which generates a mountain of points and free gifts. It is my ultimate F you to the banking system. I take advantage of banks. Banks do not take advantage of me. As for how much all this costs, it's not as much as you think. I'm not worth billions unless you're counting pennies. I made my first million when I was 31. 5 years earlier, I was living with my mother and struggling. I, quote, retired to this dream when I was 37. With a solid eight-figure net worth, I earned thousands of dollars in monthly income interest and appreciation on investments working around the globe. No matter what I do on any day, one thing is sure: the bills get paid and work is optional. I can pursue my most implausible dreams in a life free of financial restrictions while still living extraordinarily well. Now, I don't say all this to brag. Sincerely, in the grand scheme of things, I'm a nobody. No matter how many people read and recommend this book, you won't see my work force-fed to you on the shelves in any American bookstore. In fact, you'll most likely find my work in a bookstore located in Paris, Bangkok, or Seoul, Korea. You also won't see Fastlane highlighted on any bestseller lists or featured on Goodreads. You won't read about me on some Silicon Valley blog.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.